Hey, we're back, guys. Hello. I'm going to be trying to get into this game here in a moment. Hopefully nothing breaking on us. So far, so good.
Aw, Kina's a cute little car bot.
Is that the ghost?
I think so, yeah. Korea works so much more smoothly, man.
Well, that's a good sign. You're probably going to have to solo cast just like the first bit of this game. Because I did not eat breakfast before this on account of the fact that I was dumb and streaming. So I'm eating a bagel right now real quick.
Excuse me, what now?
You heard what I said.
Yeah, I heard a bagel.
Yeah, I'm eating
like a bag.
I'm eating a bagel.
An L-shaped bag. Bagel.
I'm eating a bagel.
I'm hilarious. Alright, fine, I can do that. I would really like a bagel. I know there are bagels in Korea. I've seen them, but I don't know where they get the cream cheese. That's the real question. Or the butter, actually. I don't know where anything is. Well, Overgrowth's gonna be the first map, just like the last series. We probably will not be seeing any proxy bases here. In the top right, as the blue Terran, he's alive. And his opponent in the bottom left, as the red Terran, he's keen. He's keen on winning. So TBT, some people have experimented with mech, and I do think that mech can be pretty good now in this new patch. It's already being perfected in the last one anyway. Oh. Yeah, I know, I'm hilarious, thank you. but we have been seeing more and more, and especially the Koreans at IEM, just play bio. So I kind of expect that to happen here. I do think that, at the very least, there will be more emphasis on Vikings controlling the air, as it kind of was back in Heart of the Swarm. Like, literally, you have to get the five Vikings, you're just not playing the game that as good as it can be, because Vikings are so good right now. But it's going to start with a one base build. Both getting two gases, actually pretty identical build here, and we're going to get to see what the Vikings are like, or the tanks are like, if the Reaper-Hellion battle goes poorly, or the Banshees deal to extreme damage. It is best of three, and I really would like to see one of these guys play mech, but I guess I understand if they don't want to. If this was Gumiho, he'd be playing mech, I'll tell you that much. Well, the factories are coming down. We've been seeing a lot more one base builds, it feels like, but that could just be the timing and just like the patch. Of course, one base builds have been popular for some time in TVT. Really long time. And that's why I really like the matchup. It goes to one base, two base, or three base. And I feel like each section is so well defined, mid game, early game, late game. That's not too important. Reaper, only one of them for both, right into the reactor. Usually this is where we see the mix-up of builds. Like, one person goes to the second Reaper, or maybe, like, I don't think we actually see anyone go for a second Marine. But the point is, like, a second Reaper or not, but even the tech lab's coming down at the exact same time, and these starports are most likely going to build that first Banshee, and then what we've been seeing is right into that Raven, because the Raven also got an upgrade. Banshee, Raven, as many Vikings as you can get, kind of. At least at... good number five, I guess is a good way to put it. And then maybe a push.
Air priority still plays a pretty important factor in the matchup, but you brought up the Raven, and I just really got to drive home how good the auto turret is, guys. Especially with everyone opening Banshees the way they do. That auto turret can wreck a Banshee. Seriously, no exaggeration.
Yeah, it actually kills it so quickly that when usually you can micro away from it, the acceleration is quite bad. Oh. And I'm gonna freak out for a second here.
Oh. Like, in a good way or a bad way? Oh, okay, I guess that's not gonna provide any answer, but alright. The Marines actually are high enough in number. There shouldn't be too big of an issue defending this. If there was that push in. And of course, we've seen Reapers and Hellions end games, but not gonna be the case here. The Banshee will be finishing up shortly, but Keen went straight to the Ravens, so he should be good for the defense.
Can you hear me?
Yes. What's going on?
So I guess they're like mass updating everything that needs to be updated on the computers. So the resolution is bad, and I just see League of Legends updating in front of me.
Oh, and then you might be disconnecting here. Yes, you are.
Yes, I am.
Nice.
Good news, good news.
Hey, Jack Wads, I'm busy. Do this later.
Although, yeah, right?
This is probably the best time when no one's in the cafe or PC Bong or whatever. So, she's gone. Just drop. Good thing you solo cast the first part of the game so I could solo cast the last part of the game. This is teamwork, man. The baton pass, if you will. So, I've been playing Pokemon, and I named my cat after you, obviously. Damn thing keeps trying to evolve. So annoying. And I finally looked up, like, what's the evolved form of, like, the cat thing? Have you seen it?
No.
So while you're disconnected, when you get the browser back, Google Litten. And you need to see the way that thing evolves. And I'm starting to think I'm never, ever going to let it evolve at this point. Because it does not evolve well. I'll just leave it at that.
Oh, really? It doesn't evolve into a nice little Persian cat?
No, it evolves into like a, looks like a Mexican wrestler.
Better. Oh, dear lord.
Yeah.
That's okay. What the next step of the cat lady.
Oh, luchadore. Alright, well, the Raven and the Marines were enough to drive the Banshee back. Alive, not wanting to lose the Banshee, actually brought it back home. In so many instances, we've seen Banshees suicided for much worse and for much less, but I guess really wanting to keep it alive. It's probably going to play a bigger role with the way tanks interact in the game now and how hard they are to remove from a position, so it's not a bad choice. Vikings, of course, being made behind this too. Both players. Now, Keen's going to be a little bit better because his orbital's on location, but as Alive moves his over, both players are on similar worker counts, so it's ultimately not too influential. I guess this comes to a bit of an awkward stall, as both players now decide whether they want to go into bio or mech. Tank dynamic is huge, the Viking dynamic is huge, but nobody's really committed to anything like Stim or a second production facility. So, the ultimate 1-1-1 as far as building production goes. And, well, Keen's going to be the one to move out across the map. Now, there is this funny part of Overgrowth a lot of people forgot about, we talked about before, was you can unload your tanks here, siege them up, and they can reach this mineral line. And from a quote-unquote safe distance. I don't know whether they'll be super great to do that in TBT or not, but the Banshee gets caught. However, the Banshee also sees where the army was moving, so Alive had time to position a little bit late to the party, and Keen gets his tanks up in that spot. Vikings actually do favor Alive, so you can put a point defense turn if he wants, but the auto turret drop. Tank's gonna blow him to bits, but this is gonna cost him 10 SCVs in the process. Keen getting some very nice damage done with this attack. I love the logic that the PC owners are being passive aggressive against you. Like, can this white girl take a hint? We're so sick of her being here every night at 1 a.m. Or I guess 4 a.m., whatever. But, anyways, the defense is pretty solid. It's bad for Live in terms that he's behind in workers, but he is going for a third CC, whereas Keen is going to be going bio and sticking to what appears to be a two-base all-in. So if he's not going to expand, this is where Live can maybe get a bit of an edge. It is worth noting, with TVT being the dynamic that was pre-patch combined with all the strengths gained in this patch, Defender's advantage is stronger than ever, and it's going to be really difficult for Keen to move in here unless he just has insanely overwhelming numbers. His number dropping tanks to more opportune positions. If Keen gets a good defensive spot with his own tanks, uprooting him is going to be very difficult. But the same goes for Keen, too. Like, if he gets on the offense and he roots himself in with those tanks, Alive's not going to be able to push him back very easily. There's about four tanks right outside the natural, so Alive should be okay. He's still got the Viking control, which is a pretty big deal. No, actually, I take that back. I didn't realize that the One's coming out of King from the south. So a lot of energy on both these Ravens. Not sure if point defense drones or seeker missiles are going to be preferable, but looks like it's going to be point defense drones. Now the Viking War might get completely demolished. Will that Skrull alive over? Those Vikings can land. Those Vikings can deal a lot of damage to tanks. That reminder that they deal bonus 8 damage to anything mechanical. However, it looks like with the vision alone, he's able to knock down one of the refineries, and now Alive's going to be missing out on a round of gas. Medivac gets sniped here too, and Alive is in a lot of trouble. Alive is actually in like borderline game-endingly a lot of trouble. There's no way for him to deal with the Vikings, and they still just keep coming. The tanks start leapfrogging forward, he gets the positioning here, the medevac gets sniped again, and Alive is just not able to do anything. He can't even unseage the tanks to pull him away. That's the downside. Like, 70 damage a shot! Everything here is dying the second it takes shots. Double medevacs then load up here to the north might be a mistake. The one thing Alive can do is fight with Marines. King's got an upgrade lead, which is kind of nice. Oh, and Alive doesn't even have Stim yet. Ooh, that's going to be nasty. That finishes up here shortly. Plus one will be joining with it, but combat shields is massively ahead for Keen, so better for him too. I think the tank spot really, though, just solidifies his position. We got a Liberator coming in now, and there's no way to drive off this Liberator. Those tanks are going to die. Pulling them back's not great either, because that opens up positioning now to move forward. These tanks taking quite the beating. Raven's still alive, kind of forgot about this. Got auto turrets ready to go as well. Already on like 5 kills, but let's not forget those auto turrets are going to be able to knock back most of what's left as well. So, again, everything here just looks better. The third command center tries to land. It's going to go down. Oh, it's not even just burning. It's going to go down. The Marines completely shut down the third base dead of Alive. And this, it just doesn't get better. Down to half the army supply. Taking any sort of fight just seems like it's out of the question. Auto turrets do come down. 24 damage a shot, but also soaking hits. Flank for the bottom side. Marines push in. Viking's going to probably just land at this point. There's nothing left for Alive. And Keen is going to absolutely dominate here for game number one. Not being one to tap out, though. Not without pulling the SCVs. Liberator's still set up in this, too. That tank moves forward, and that is just... There we go. Finally, GG's. How are things going on the PC Bong side of things, Zombie Grobe?
Well, good news, Rifkin. Counter-Strike 2 has been updated.
Oh, Counter-Strike 2? Not Counter-Strike Go, but Counter-Strike 2?
Nope. 2? Counter-Strike 2 Online.
Is this Windows XP that they've updated it on? Is that how that
works? I don't know, man. The game.
Hello Zergling just reset for 26 months and says Ace1, Ace2, thanks Corsair and Base Trade TV for rescuing us from Mondays. Mondays.
Tuesday morning.
So is StarCraft still updating?
No, but everything else is. I don't know if it's going to force StarCraft to quit again. I get it.
All right, well, we'll go to a commercial break then. I just informed Alive and Keen what's going on, so hopefully it won't be too long. Worst comes to worst, I can just solo cast and we'll catch you up in the finals type thing. But I'll be back in a couple minutes, guys. Thanks for watching. All right, back for the commercial break, guys. Unfortunately, Zombie still doesn't have her game up yet, so I think I'm just going to tell these guys they can go without her so we can get the show going. And
it's okay.
We can go without her. That way. Whenever we're ready. Alive's asking a lot of questions about you, so I was like, dude, just ask her on a date. And he's like, really? Where in Seoul is living? Maybe you got a date coming your way, they zombie grub. I don't know.
Oh my god. Stop poking me up.
Sorry. Am I too good a boing man? Is that what's happening right now?
Yeah, you're too good of a wingman of all the Koreans.
Alright, well, I'll tell him good luck, go. And if this goes to game 3, hopefully Zombie Girl will be back by then. If it goes to the finals, hopefully Zombie Girl will be back by then. But either way, we'll just give it another round of good old solo casting. I hope you guys do like our solo casting one way or the other, because we're going to be trading off a day coming up on, I think it's Wednesday, or let me check the schedule real quick. Yeah, on Wednesday, Zomgrub's going to be solo casting the Leifang Cup and Group B, and I'm going to be solo casting the Top Dogs Finals, since those two events are too far apart that making a double day out of it would probably kill us.
Yeah.
Well, I want to see something, Zombie Grub. This is going to test your TBT knowledge, okay?
Okay.
It's on Echo. And I want you to cast the best you can until you're just absolutely wrong, and I'll let you know, okay?
Okay, they opened up one base.
Alright, so spawning in the bottom right side of the map is going to be the red Terran player alive.
Am I supposed to do the positions too?
Well, I mean, it's top left, it's Echo. I know where it can, it's not a four player spawn map.
I didn't think you were actually supposed to make me cast. That was more like, what do you think you're doing now? What do you think you're doing now?
Go.
In the top left, it's the other player.
Did you forget who was playing already?
Alive.
No, I said alive. It's Keen. You've already messed this up. This has failed miserably. Can you at least guess what color he is?
Alive?
Yeah. No,
alive. Keen? Red.
No, I said alive was red. You couldn't be more wrong on both counts. This is worse than Xenosiders intros in 2015. Oh my god.
So in the bottom left, right?
Stop. All right,
oh,
Zombie Grub.
Fine, let's keep doing this.
I will report in. Keen and Alive have both taken both their gases. And they've both gone for that barracks into a quicker looking factory. Nobody expanded.
One Reaper into Starport, Banshee, then Raven.
Don't get too far ahead of yourself. Leave some room for error, woman. Oh my goodness, Riamar just threw in 2,500 bits!
Yay.
Alive has a crush on Zombie Grub? Maybe.
Everyone has a crush on me. I look beautiful online. You see them in real life and you're like, oh, I'm gonna sink.
You're fine in real life too, man. Whatever. The real kicker here though is Alive is not the type of guy to bring you flowers. Alive's the kind of guy to learn enough English to invite you to a game that has a map mod already made with it. Alive is I will say he's ahead of the pack. If I was in your shoes, I think he's ahead of the pack.
Ask him if he wants to get Bosom.
I don't know how to spell that. And also, I don't have referee.
Just guess.
I'm going to end up spelling like, do you want to get Bulma? Okay, so they've both kept the Reapers at home, both on patrol outside the natural, but nobody actually taking a command center. They're both having their starports actually finish up in just a moment's time. It looks like Tech Labs are ready to swap over, so make the call, Zombie Grub. Oh, quick note, Keen's actually building a Widow Mine with two Marines.
They gonna go Banshees?
Well, what is Alive doing with his starport, do you think?
He's gonna go Banshees.
Okay, and what do you think Keen's doing with his starport?
Going Banshee.
Okay, one out of two. Now here's the question. Who is it that made the Raven?
The guy that made the Widow Mine.
No, incorrect.
Really? Damn.
Also, I feel like keeping track of the names shouldn't be that difficult. Again, Keen
like
went for the Widow Mine. You're like, the guy who went for the Widow Mine. Oh, I do have referee. I could ask him. How do I... No, I shouldn't distract
him. No, don't ask him while he's playing a game.
Yeah, I know. That's rude.
People loved my intro.
Yeah, it sounds like you super nailed it. Is this a drunk cast or a sober cast? You wouldn't be able to tell. So Keen's gonna follow up with the Raven. You're done. You're done, kid. Take a seat. Get on the bench. Take
Wait,
a knee.
Keen's following up with the Raven.
Keen's building a Raven now.
Got there. Eventually.
Alive already has the Raven. He went for the Raven first with no Banshee whatsoever. But Alive is going straight to double Vikings. So no Banshees and no points for you.
Aww.
Points. The Banshee comes in, tags one of the SCVs, but really can't do too much more. Especially with the Vikings out. Siege Tank sets up two in the natural, and oh, that there's a Widow Mine in the middle of the map. Maybe I'll catch some units walking by later.
Mm-hmm.
We've actually seen this be really annoying before. How much money is 2,500 bits? So I think that's approximately $25. What we've kind of learned is, if you start axing off the zero, like two zeros, that's the approximate amount of bits they're worth. So, Riamar, by the way, has donated like
$100.
12,500 bits today, I want to say. quite a bit. So thank you, Riomar, for your intense generosity, dude. I mean, Riomar was also one of the people who I think were the final consideration for us to finally enable bits, too. He's one of the guys who really wanted it, so glad to see he's using it.
Yep. So good news. Stop updating, but there's nothing in the way of me clicking on that on a launcher. And the Windows search doesn't bring me any games.
Can you not just like ask them what's going on or get a different PC that works?
Can maybe get a different PC. I'm actually not sure how that works. Because they have like the thing tagged into this computer.
But I mean, the whole reason you're there is for StarCraft. If that one PC can't run StarCraft, what good is
it? Oh, it can run it. I literally just can't click on the icon.
Oh, then I have clearly misunderstood what the problem here is.
Okay, I fixed it, actually. I just made them on the desktop appear over everything else.
Alright, Scan from Keen, by the way, checking out Alive's base. This is going to be a pretty big deal to Scan, because he did reach out for his third. Scan's the third base to confirm that Alive's also doing the same, and that it's not going to be some crazy two-base all-in. Now, luckily, he was able to see the count of the air army, and, of course, I think the biggest thing was the additional barracks being come down. So, knowing that it's not going to be something weird in mech, but instead just classic and bio. Keen's production's actually a little bit behind, actually, by a significant amount. So a little bit worried here. Not going to be too influential over the next minute or two of the game, but it will be for the next, let's say, 3 or 4 minutes of the game. And there'll be a whole extra round of buildings done, as Keen's only just started building it. Not to Minch, who could it be? Resubs for 12 months, says my sensors indicate that Zombie Grub is a 10 out of 10 on the hot scale. Beep boop. Stream Zombie Grub is a 10 out of 10 on the hot scale. Real life Zombie Grub's 10 correct. Out of 10 on a completely different scale.
I'm fine with being 10 pounds.
What?
Sorry to go with that.
No, how on earth would you make me... In what world do you think I'm like, yeah, she only weighs 10 pounds, guys. She's she's like basically a paper thin, no bones.
I was doing
bones.
That thing where you were probably going to tell me that I was like 1,000 pounds. Because I'm a 10-10 on their scale.
No, I was going to say you're a 10 out of 10 on the grumpy scale. I don't know where this weight thing came from.
I have not been grumpy at all today, good sir.
You done?
Now I am.
Now you're grumpy? See, it works. Called it. This is whatever. Okay, so +2 weapons and +2 armor startup for Alive. He's already up upgrades by a good margin. It's not going to be such a lead that I think Keen's going to be trailing for long, but there will be these gaps in the game where Alive's going to be up an upgrade lead. And those are the types of engagements you want to try and be able to pounce upon. They don't happen often, and you'll usually hear casters, especially us, talk about the potential of it. Because when the odd time it does happen, it's so obvious that there's upgrades at a disadvantage, because the Marines it's like watching two different units fight. But falling back in the middle, Keen has not really got a lot of pushing power in him. I think he's just trying to get a lot of scouting. I mean, he's got the Marines spread out all over the map. He really wants to see where Alive's coming from when he comes, and this one awkward Marine will get a couple shots on that Raven. And then 4 Marines are gonna not bully him back? Okay, this was like a weird instance of like, I'll get my brother to fight you. Worked out really well for Keen though. 4 Marines for no losses. This Marine got obliterated so hard that he just exploded into black goop. Upgrades also kick it off for vehicles. I actually are very worthwhile now, especially since tanks already get such a big upgrade boost, plus that 70 damage turns into like 80 damage. It's huge. These little Marine scuffles going on around the middle of the map are favoring Keen every time, so he is pulling a little bit ahead in supply, now up on 88 army supply to the 79 of Alive, but these tanks, rooted in such a good position, are going to be very difficult to break. This comes down to that defender's advantage, it comes down to the fact that tanks deal so much damage. I mean, seriously guys, again, 70 damage a shot to anything armored, to other tanks specifically. Takes down the rocks, the debris fall pretty quick. Another command center starts up here out of Alive, so he'll be moving over to that fourth as soon as he gets the opportunity. But upgrade lead is in the favor of Alive again, so he's not just got the vehicle weapon upgrades over Keen. He's got 2-2 to the 1-1, so Marines will fight better too. I love chat calling out your math, by the way. We're in what world is 10 times 10 a thousand to call you a 1,000 pounds?
No, I didn't even catch that. 1010. 1,010 pounds.
Oh, nice recovery, Zamigo.
We'll play. Literally what I was thinking.
Oh, these medevacs get caught fully loaded. Vikings looking for some kills, but Keen pulls back just in the nick of time. A little bit scary there for him. Again, the reminder here is that Alive is the one currently behind in the series, so he's got to not die to this. Attack commences, and the Viking count actually favors Keen going into this. So while he's not been able to get any headway, he has created this very awkward, informal contain. If he's able to shut down this fourth base, that's going to be pretty massive. I think Alive's anticipating this too, so he moves the army. Keen decides to stim in, but realizing at the last second that would be a bad choice, stims out. Now, of course, that command center becomes a hot point of contention because neither army is really in position for it right now. And if Alive dedicates everything to the right, Keen might just push in through the south. But the tanks are going to get the first shots out of the blue side. Leaving the Marines to the north, though, to wrap around. He takes his Marines out of position. There's nothing guarding the tanks, so the Marines jump on top of the tanks, and Keen loses all of his tanks on the front line. Alive loses a lot of Marines, but he's certainly got more than enough to kind of, I guess, guard the remaining tanks out of Alive. I mean, it's 12 tanks to 5 now. That was a big mistake. The Marines wanted to get over here, and a big part of the timing was Keen was trying to hit this before it became the orbital, or the planetary, excuse me, but it still goes down. It dies. He pulls back, and that fourth base out of Alive, not going to go up today. Problem is, though, while he does get his own fourth base up, he lost all the medevacs in that attack. A lot of the tanks dead, and Keen's staying power on the other side of the map just isn't there. He even starts up a fifth base. He's feeling bold. He takes a fifth base behind this. Meanwhile, on the right side, we do have the command center trying to build out of Alive, but that's going to be a little bit of time before it's up. The Liberator is an interesting choice, considering that he does have the Viking air control in this, but it's one Liberator. Hell, even two or three Liberators still going to take some time to push this back. Oh, he's got to break some debris field. A little bit awkward there. 8 Vikings to 0. I mean, at this point, Keen is pretty much locked down the air superiority. I just don't know if 2 Liberators is going to be enough to break Alive's defense just yet. It is slowly forcing him out of position, though, as you watch him constantly have to maneuver around the Liberators. Oh, ouch. No need to hiccup. Please, calm down. Upgrades for Alive are better, sitting on that 3-3. Plus, it's got plus 3 vehicle weapons coming out soon, too. So these tanks are hitting for 80 damage a shot. I mean, we're almost in 2-shot range for a lot of these siege tanks, not to mention splash damage. But Liberator set up and gets into the tank fire. Marine's going to steam into this one Liberator. Not going to get it, though. The tanks have got it covered. So pushing Alive back once again, and Keen finds himself in a very opportune position. However, I take that back. Planetary Fortress on the north side gets surrounded, picked off by the Marines. Tank set up. Keen's got to fall back with his own Marines to try and chase this army back. But those medevacs, they're going to try and get out of there alive. He loses all the Marines in the process. That's so much cannon fodder gone from the game now, and Alive doesn't have that protecting his tanks. This is where the Liberators start edging up once again, and he scans to confirm this. But even though the Liberator's a little bit out of position, the tanks have got it covered. Marines stim underneath this. They pick off one of the 2 Liberators, but it's costing him all of his Marines. Also, so many medevacs in the sky out of Alive. Still sitting there. Like, very few have actually died this game, actually. Only one medevac has died, but the rest of them, as you can see, are in the red. Very low, very close to death. Marines on the north side, some siege tanks finding a good spot to siege up over here towards that planetary fortress. SCVs provide some vision, cost-efficient scans, but still not worth it if he loses them all. Gonna unload the Marines on top of the tank. Friendly fire is gonna help dish out the damage, and Alive is just losing out everything on the front lines. Last couple tanks getting the shots. One managed to survive with the planetary, but that planetary's in range of that command, or that one tank, so it's gonna slowly bleed out. He's gonna have to pull some SCVs to repair it at some point. Meanwhile, the base in the top right has a Marine here, but awkwardly enough has not been scouted, so Keen doesn't know about the top rightmost base. Alive might just get away with that for a little bit of time, all things considered. But more tanks arriving on the front line. Supply gap just starting to be a little too hard to overcome. Almost 40 supply difference between these two players when it comes to army value alone. As pointed out, the planetary was getting incredibly low, so the tank finally has to take a bit of a breather. They repair it up. Looks like this drop's going down on the left side, but Keen's pretty on top of this with his reinforcements, just kind of collecting everything that he can. Plus the weapons finish up. Looks like he's going to try and push into the ramp a little bit. That just takes him closer to the Liberators, however. 85 damage a shot from the siege tank. Not going to be good enough, and Keen going to take game number two and lock down this series 2-0, sending us back to Europe. That was the most golf clappiest, like,
no, I'll happily believe this.
That's true. Is there a blue light in there? Or is there just no light in there? You're suddenly looking very blue. Unless, are you feeling okay?
I'm really sad right now.
Why are you really sad right now, Zombie Grub? Because you couldn't get into the game?
I'm going to play, press F for respects for my cat.
Oh. Well, I mean, you did get like a million Twitter messages yesterday. I think everyone's already paid their respects for your cat.
And they did it again. It made me sad. No, it's actually just there is light in front of me, but it's just highlighting blue light that's coming up from underneath all of the desks. I don't know why.
It's weird. But okay, now we get to go back to the incredibly frustrating European server where I'm sure things are going to cop out and die and not work and hopefully get these finals over in due time. It is the best of five coming up. PVT, Liquid, shut the fuck. Liquid Mana versus Keen. We'll see you guys in a little bit after this ad break.